What are fats? What are lipids? Today, we're going to talk about fats that are also known as, well, lipids. So what exactly are fats? Why do you actually need to eat them? Are they good? Are they bad? Are there different types? How much fat should I eat? We'll answer those questions and more in this video. So let's check it out. Now, before we get into it, don't forget to click like, subscribe, and share this content to learn more. Now, fats, what are they? They aren't necessarily something bad that adds fat and weight to our bodies when we eat them. They are so much more than that. Without fats, we simply couldn't survive. We would actually die if we did not have fat. In this video, we're going to talk exactly about what fat is, the main types of fat, and where they are found. We're going to talk about roles the fat plays in our body, as well as how much and what kinds we should try to eat. So let's get into it. First, let's talk about what exactly a fat is on the smallest molecular level. Fats, scientifically, are known as lipids. They are organic compounds, or in other words, they are from living things. They consist mainly of hydrogen, carbon, and oxygen atoms, and are generally insoluble in water, which means they can't dissolve in water. You know the saying, we go together like oil and water. Or another way of saying that is, we go together like fat and water. Now, there are three main types of fats or lipids called triacylglycerols, better known as triglycerides, phospholipids, and sterols. About 95% of fats in our diets come from triglycerides, and we commonly call them fats when they are in solid form and oils when they're in the liquid form. They're found in foods such as fried foods, vegetable oil, butter, whole milk, cheese, and some meats. And triglycerides are also found in foods like avocado, corn, olives, and nuts. Now the second type of fat, phospholipids, only make up about 2% of the fat in our diets. And unlike other fats, they can be dissolved in water. And they're found primarily in foods kind of like, well, eggs, milk, soy, red meat, chicken, fish, liver, as well as some seeds and grains. And the last type of fats are sterols. And they make up at least part of the fats in our diet, but the most common type of sterol, which you've likely heard of, is cholesterol. And now we get a small amount of cholesterol from our diet, but our bodies, the liver to be exact, actually creates most of what it needs all by itself. So the cholesterol in our diet comes also from foods such as eggs and shellfish and meats and dairy products. Now, let's talk about what fats do for our bodies. Because fats are good for our body, we need to know that fat serves several main purposes. The first function is that fats serve as a structural component for our cell membranes. They help us have healthy cells. Simply put, they're the building block for our bodies. The second function is fats serve as energy storage. Any excess energy we get from food is stored as adipose or fatty tissue. Now, in the last video about carbohydrates, we mentioned how carbs are our body's main source of energy, and fats are our body's secondary reserve of energy, and they're able to store more energy in a smaller amount of space. In fact, a gram of fat has more than twice the amount of energy than a gram of carbs. So while most cells in the body can store a limited amount of fat, specialized fat cells can expand almost without limit. However, too much of this fatty tissue can have many negative effects on our health. So while we need some fatty tissue to survive, it can be harmful to our health in large quantities. Now, thirdly, fats help with regulating our bodies. Triglycerides help our bodies to maintain a normal constant temperature. If our bodies do not have enough fat, it can actually lead to us having greater fatigue and feeling physically cold more often. Fats also help the body to produce and regulate hormones. And additionally, they play an important part in our nerve impulse transmission. You know, it makes the nerves work. Another purpose of fat is to physically insulate and protect our body. Now, we have a layer of fat under our skin all over to keep us insulated in places like our palms and to serve as a cushion, to reduce stress and friction. Also, a layer of fat around vital organs helps protect them also. Lastly, the fats we eat also aid in our digestion and absorption of certain fat-soluble nutrients. So vitamins like A, D, E, and K are best absorbed by our bodies when eaten with fat. Without fat in our foods, it is actually harder for us to absorb nutrients from some of our foods. So after learning about all the functions of fats, it's easy to see that at least some fat is an essential part of our diet. But are all fats good for us? And the simple answer is no, they're not. And this is where we're gonna break it down a little more for you. Now, there's four types of triglycerides: saturated, monounsaturated, polyunsaturated, and trans fats. Monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fats both have many, many health benefits. Monounsaturated fats found in things like avocados, nuts, and olive oil, and they're beneficial to our health in many ways, including helping to lower your bad cholesterol levels. Now, polyunsaturated fats, which includes things like omega-3, omega-6 fatty acids, are found in things like certain fatty fish, some vegetable oils, as well as particular seeds and nuts. And the fatty acids found in these foods can help reduce the inflammation in your body and lower your risk of heart disease. And although these foods with monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fats are good for you, they still need to be consumed in moderation. Now, the next type of triglyceride is saturated fats. And these are generally found in the solid state at room temperature and are found in foods like chocolate, meat, and dairy products, as well as coconut oil. Now, they've been linked to causing the liver to create more bad cholesterol, but more research is still being done on these types of fats and their impacts on our overall health. They're not quite as healthy as unsaturated fats, and it's best to eat them in moderation. Now, the final type of fats are trans fats. And these trans fats are found in processed foods like, you know, your cookies, your chips, your pizzas, and basically any commercial baked good or fast food. And these fats were created when manufacturers wanted to extend the shelf life of certain products. However, these fats have been shown to increase bad cholesterol levels in our bodies, as well as decrease, you know, a double hit, a decrease to our good cholesterol. And they've also been linked to increased risks of heart disease. So really, there's absolutely no health benefits to these man-made trans fats. So it's best just to avoid them or eat them only extremely occasionally. And although there are some foods with small amounts of natural trans fats, curiously, they don't seem to have within them the same health risks associated with them as manufactured trans fats. So here's the next question. How much fat should we eat? Well, the American Health Association suggests that fat should account for 20 to 35% of our daily calorie intake, and unsaturated fat should make about 15 to 25% of those fats. Saturated fats should make about 10% or less, and trans fats less than 1. So there you have it. Fats are an essential part of our health and diets, and we can't survive without them, but we do need to be careful of how much and what types we regularly consume. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Go ahead and click subscribe, like, and share, and you all have a good one.